The contemporary scramble for the American conscience is most astonishingly prevalent at this current moment in time. My name is William F. Buckley, and with me to discuss this matter at hand is the representative of New York's 14th Congressional District, Miss Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Yeah, hi, yeah.
Beside her is a man.
It's ma'am!
Sorry, ma'am, who goes by the alphabetical character, the letter Z.
My name is Z, fascist!
And last but not least, Anglo-American journalist, Mr. Christopher Hitchens. Thank you very much for having me, Mr. Buckley. Now, Miss Cortez, you have established the notion that the world is on the brink of an eschatological end, and that the United States is the de facto agitator to this end.
If that's what I said, then yeah, call me a radical.
Yes, well, you have made the affirmation that the world will end in 12 quick trips around the sun.
I was only joking when I said that. I wasn't serious.
Oh, you were only joking?
Yeah, I like to show people that I have a sense of humor.
Do you?
Yeah, here's one. What do you call an alligator detective?
No idea.
An investigator. You get it?
The four most overrated things in life are champagne, lobster, anal sex, and the Green New Deal. Look, Miss Ocasio-Cortez claims to have made an elementary joke at the expense of those listening. But the sad truth is that she actually believed what she said. Her credulity is beyond comprehension. It's beyond comprehension.
Who are you?
Let's retract a bit. Mr. Z.
It's ma'am! For the last time.
Oh, sorry, Mrs. Z. What do you distinguish to be the formative ideal regarding the American conscience?
You talk funny.
That doesn't answer the question.
Questions are fascist. Hello?
Now, Mrs. Z, you identify as non-binary / trans fluid.
Yes, it means whatever gender I feel, I can choose. And it can change anytime. Like, right now, if you're lucky. William F. Lee.
Madam Z, do you determine your sex or gender by the toss of a coin or by the rolling of dice?
Well, Mr. Buckley, I would have to admit that I too am transfluid. I can switch over from wine to scotch in a relatively short period of time without getting sick.
I'm sorry, my anxiety is like really bad right now. I need to tweet about it.
Ms. Cortez, what are you tweeting exactly?
I'm tweeting about how you're mocking Mr. Z.
It's ma'am!
Oh my God, Z, I am so sorry. My anxiety and depression are just really bad right now.
There was once a way people would deal with anxiety and depression. Mr. Buckley, old chap, I'm sure you recall.
I do recall. I think it was called not being a pussy.
Yes, thus it seems to me to be the cliché these days, which as a man who detests clichés, I don't like it. I don't like it at all.
Mr. Hitchens, what would you say is exactly the contemporary norm in American society?
Yes, its manifestation is quite profound. Not in an affirmative or positive sense, though. What we have is a youth whose culture is that of decadence and who are extremely self-loathing and at the same time self-righteous indeed. Trained throughout academia as cattle, domesticated and possessed, and sometimes, I will say, castrated in concerning Mr. Z by extremely bloated professors and journalists alike.
You're a bloated journalist.
Hey, that's fat shaming. How do you not know?
Oh my God, I am so sorry. I have to apologize.
Do you have to apologize on Twitter all the time?
Yeah, it's the only way that my fans will know that I'm a decent person.
What's wrong with expressing ourselves on Twitter, you crypto-Nazi?
Now listen here, you call me a crypto-Nazi again, I'll sock you in your goddamn face and you'll stay plastered.
I think I need a scotch right now.
Likewise.
Off to your smoke-filled patriarchy, I see, huh?
I don't think she knows the proper meaning of the word.
What is the proper meaning?
I won't tell.
Mr. Buckley, I have a bottle of Johnny Walker Black waiting for us at the Hamilton. Reservations indeed, accept no substitutes.
Now, Hitchens, you can have scotch. I'll be doing a gin martini. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us on tonight's firing line. I am off to the Hamilton to go discourse on matters at hand with Christopher Hitchens while getting extremely inebriated beyond the highest extent. Thank you very much.